Hello, beautiful people. In today's episode, we're gonna look at active and semi-active flow states and what that means. Flow state is basically a state of mind and body where you are present in the moment and where you're focusing on what you're doing but allowing your brain to process elements in the background. This helps you process information, data that you store throughout your life without necessarily poking at it directly. Let's start with the semi-active flow state. This is basically an activity that you enjoy doing. It could look like cooking, dancing, doing yoga in a way that is not too physically active, walking, anything like that that you would enjoy doing and that you usually do potentially. The idea is not to focus on the end goal of it, but to focus on the journey of it, so on the moment while you're doing it. And as you do that, to basically smile and to be happy doing it. So it has to be something you enjoy doing and that you're not forced to do. So in the case of cooking, try to cook something that you enjoy cooking. You want to protect a bit of time, even if it's not a lot. You want that time to be relatively peaceful in the sense that you're not pulled everywhere to go do something else right away. So often when you do something you enjoy, you get into a flow state without noticing it. This is where you should basically focus on if you want to know if you're there or not. Basically, it's gonna fill you with a sense of happiness, or joy, or simplicity, or something along those lines, which basically allow you to do the task and enjoy doing it, and once you're done, you're happy you've done it. And while you're doing this, basically it's helping your brain process information. So the state is not necessarily fully defined, and I couldn't point out to you precisely what your flow state would look like, because it's different for everyone. But the main idea of it is that it flows, and it is easy to be in it. It is not challenging. It should feel comfortable to do your activity. Some people may refer this as being in the zone, especially while you're doing something. You don't necessarily focus on what you're doing in the sense that it's not difficult. So you have ease at doing it. And you're just doing it because you enjoy it and you like it and quote unquote, it's easy for you. And that allows you to basically go through the different steps of your brain going from, you know, I know what I'm doing or I need to learn something or no, this I know how to do and I enjoy it. And then I can focus on something else while this is happening. Just like meditation, you need to make time for it, for the activity and to be mindful when you're doing it. So maybe it's something you already do, it's just that you're gonna change a tiny bit your approach to it. Pick something that you enjoy doing and spend a bit of time on it. Try to gauge how you feel before and after. The challenge with all of that is that you won't necessarily see an obvious change from before and after because you are doing something that you enjoy, but it will help your brain manage things. So the idea is to do it more often, more like an exercise than just once in a while, in order to actually help you build a behavior for your brain to process elements that are running in the background. Sometimes you may be super busy and not have time for something like painting in your mind. And you should change that mindset because doing this activity for you is actually really important. That's what's going to allow you to regain some of your brain bandwidth and to actually do your work better or whatever it is that you need to get done. Because your brain will have the opportunity to relax and to process information. Releasing your bandwidth so you can use it in other productive ways. Now let's speak about being in a more active flow state. Well, first, this is gonna happen while you're doing a sport. Now, the kind of sport you would want to be doing for that is a sport that you do alone. So you're talking about climbing, running, cycling, swimming, anything that does not involve other people and that is not done in team or that has an active challenger against you. The entire idea behind it is to activate all your body and for your brain to focus on that. And basically, as you do this, you try to if you can, depending on the exercise, breathe through it and be aware that you're using your body, and be aware of the sensation in your body. And once you become aware of the sensation in your body, you're really using your brain to focus on the now and the actual physical activity, which in turn is going to release a bunch of your bandwidth to process what is in the background. This is why you often hear people, "I'm going for a run because I need to think." It's basically that entire process, and people are doing it often without noticing it. The entire idea about it, again, if you already do it, is to focus on it a bit more, and if you don't, to find such an activity, because maybe that's what you need, and to actually do it in that way, so that this becomes the moment where you get some peace, even if your mind is running, or you get some quiet, even if you're trying to resolve something in your mind, because that activity will help your body balance itself out and your brain run properly. The main difference between a semi-active and an active flow state is the state of your body, actually. In a semi-active, you are actually able to think about what you're doing and put intent into it. In a fully active state, your intent is more around the physical activity that you're doing. So the difference is very big between the two. Yet for the brain, both are good. And finding which style works for you is very important. Because you might be in a situation where it's a lot easier for you to actually go for a run or go for a bike ride than it is to do a semi-active one. Because when you're in the house, potentially you're always busy doing something. So finding what works for you is key here. And doing it often enough to build a habit again for your brain to get used to processing things is a key part of it. The goal is not to change how you do sports, but really to do them with a mindset that maybe something else is going to happen and to be aware of that. As you open your awareness to how the brain works, you may see results that you already had before, just weren't aware, which means you're going to be able to track them and build upon them. Join me next week when we're going to talk about how to find your style of flow state and what is good for you. If you liked today's video, hit the subscribe button, that helps us a lot.